We've come to Gloucester, Massachusetts. We want to narrow down the hunt for North America's second Viking site and to find their utopia called Vinland.
Cool spot, huh?
Yeah.
In Denmark, we saw the type of ships that the Vikings explored with. But the key to solving this 1,000-year-old puzzle could lie in the sagas.
This proves that the Vikings were here, but we still don't know how far south they traveled.
The clues in the writing suggest they may have traced the coast of Canada before leaving the southernmost point of Nova Scotia. The descriptions say they sailed out of sight of land for 2 days before arriving at a place they called Vinland, named after the grapes they found growing there. So where is Vinland? The only way to solve this mystery is to sail, just like the Vikings did.
Wow, look at this.
Oh, yes. That is beautiful.
Wow.
Polaris is the only Viking vessel of its kind in North America. Establishing how fast the ship can sail will help us narrow down the possible location of Vinland and a second Viking site.
We know from the sagas that they were on the open water for 2 days.
Yeah. Doing a speed test on Polaris will tell us how far they could have gotten in those 2 days.
Man, can we get down there?
Ready to row?
Let's do it.
The 38-foot Polaris is an exact replica of one of the Roskilde relics.
Hey, hey.
Hey.
How are you?
Good. How are you guys?
Doing very well.
Arista Holden has a master captain's license and will be overseeing our speed test on the Polaris.
How are you?
It's a copy of Skoldalev 6, which is the Krakafir in Roskilde, Denmark.
Krakafir? That's what they call blue sometimes.
Skoldalev 6 dates from the year 1030 and would have been used for coastal voyages.
How fast does puppy go?
You want to go find out?
Oh, I'd love to find out.
All right.
Permission to come aboard?
Yeah.
Once dressed in our very non-Viking life vests, it's not long till Captain Arista is calling the shots.
Prepare to make way, two strokes, and together, one. Come to oars.
The plan is to row out of Gloucester Harbor, then raise the sail and start our speed test.
Yeah, looking good.
It's feeling a lot like work. This is way harder than I thought it would be. Paddles are kind of long and ornery.
Now on the open ocean, it's time to prepare Polaris for maximum speed.
Just seeing those bright colors, that's what makes the ship come alive. A big square sail, there's your Viking ship.
My job is to sit here and do nothing else than hold this line, which I think says something about the confidence the captain has in my crewing ability.
You suck, Mike.
But with the swell increasing, Blue's only job is to keep his lunch down.
Blue should be seriously considering a name change to Green.
I get motion sickness from playing video games, so I knew it wasn't a stretch that I was gonna get sick out here getting tossed around in the sea.
Half an hour later, Blue starts feeling better. He's finally finding his sea legs. It's time for the speed test. The ancient saga suggests the Vikings sailed south across open ocean for 2 days. We think they could have left land at the southernmost point of Nova Scotia. So, 2 days' travel from there is a good yardstick for the location of the place they christened Vinland. By calculating how fast Polaris can sail, we can work out roughly where the Vikings could have hit land. Time to test the theory.
What I suggest we do is we take speeds every 30 seconds over a course of 2 minutes, and then we'll do an average and see what it comes up as.
All right, sounds good.
Good with that?
Now, to get Polaris up to maximum speed.
Probably blowing 10, 12 knots right now.
It's all hands on deck as the sail is trimmed.
We need more power.
Arista focuses on holding our course.
All right, ready?
At last, we're ready.
All right, I've got our speed up on the GPS, and when you are ready, Arissa, we will get going.
All right, I'll mark in 3, 2, 1, mark.
Boom. All right, 3.9.
Not a bad speed. Arista says it's about average for a craft like Polaris.
3, 2, 1, mark.
All right, 4 knots. That's the 1 minute mark.
Arista makes the best of the wind, and it's showing. We're increasing our speed.
3, 2, 1, mark.
4.3.
That's the fastest we've gone all day.
All right, let's add those together, divide them, and see what we get.
We're averaging 4.18 knots.
4.18 knots.
That feels about right.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good clip.
But how far would this have got the Vikings?
We want to imagine how far they could travel at this speed over the course of 2 days. We want to multiply this by 48 hours, and what do we get?
200.64 nautical miles.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, that's a good distance.
I think we can say with some confidence that this average speed would be enough to get the Vikings from Nova Scotia all the way down to New England.
2 days sailing and 200 nautical miles could mean the Vikings made landfall in the Cape Cod area of Massachusetts.